Hello, today we're looking at Makulu Linux Flash 15. It is part of the Makulu 15 series. We already looked at Lindox, which is basically Windows with the fully Linux feeling. Now we are looking at Flash, and then there's also Core. So they got three releases, and this is a very cool one for me. You get the Windows feeling in it, with the Linux feeling, with complete old schoolness. So it's a very interesting setup. You don't have the welcoming app which you had in Lindox, and the tools, and this is not based on Cinnamon, it's based on XFCE. And as you can see, it's a very fascinating system. There is three launchers in this system. One launcher sometimes work when you hovering here, but then never can get it to work. Then you got your type launcher, it's much more cooler here, and you can just type in what you want, and it will launch for you. So that's a really cool little launcher option, which they brought in here, and then they got the familiar menu. So even though it is based on XFCE and not on Cinnamon, it's still got the Linux Mint feeling. As you can see, the home folder looks really cool. The sources, let's update the sources first before I'm going to the updates. And it's Linux kernel 4.18, and it's based on Debian. Let's make absolutely sure what version of Debian is. Not based on Ubuntu, but it's based on. Do some updates. Let's say yes. It's based on Debian testing, so Debian Buster, which is really cool. It's actually based on Debian Buster and not Debian Stretch, as most systems are. You got three software centers, the GNOME, the Mint software, and the Synaptic software center. So it is really interesting that they got three options. One thing which many Linux users will say why, and I also say why for it, but for people who come from Windows, many people, which I noticed in my channels, people ask about it, is antivirus. It got a built-in antivirus inside the system. And as you can see, there's many, not just your familiar XFCE apps, your Samba link, or the great Samba link. You can open up a root terminal, a folder terminal, but also you can scan for viruses in your desktop. So it's very interesting. Maybe not needed, but if you have a Windows drive and got viruses on and things like that, you can just use this as a live CD or something like that. You just plug it in your Windows hard drive and scan it for viruses. So there is ways it is very useful in this. So as you can see, it scanned one directory, found nothing, and it's actually quite a cool little app. As you can see, the update is still running. It used the Mint software download manager, but not the latest. So snapshots isn't there, and automatic updates does not exist yet, which is a pity, because that's the one thing I like quite a lot of Linux Mint, is 19 is automatic update is also an option. Apps, absolutely the latest, they use Opera as the browser. Firefox, Chromium isn't here, you have to install it yourself. And as you can see, you've got quite a few apps here. System monitor, yes, really a lot installed, but you got Downshift also, which is in Linux Mint 4 to create system snapshots, which is a really handy tool. As you can see, it uses about a gigabyte of RAM, a bit less, so it is better than your normal systems, to be honest. Windows Starling works perfectly, so it's a very nice tool that is like, you get the latest of Linux with the touch of, and the feeling of, what do I want to say? Or Windows, but you said I said old school, and where's old school? If you go to settings and you apply Compass, of course Compass must be here. And I also got a heap of beautiful wallpapers. And then look at how the settings look like immediately. The buttons have changed and it all just feels, suddenly you are in old school, old school Linux. You can configure it here. But just by, as you can see, all these buttons have changed, everything changed quickly. Boxes, even in VirtualBox, Compass at its best. And it's just for me, like, everything have suddenly become old school. In a second, with this big launch of these buttons here, and Compass in its full glory. So, I love it. It also uses Variety as the wallpaper. And as you can see, also what is displaying on your screen at the moment, which is really cool. You can't close it in your, inside your screen, but it's still really, really cool. And I think they've done a pretty awesome job in this release. Let's see if it works now here at the top. No, I can't get my Windows icons to launch from the top. If somebody can tell me exactly how to do it, please do. And besides from that, I think this guy has done a great job and good job. Please support him, and if you are using it, please send him a donation. He would really appreciate it. And yes, thank you for watching. See you later. Goodbye.